This is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this video, I will show you how to make a simulated woodcut image from a picture. The picture of the Heisenberg character from the Breaking Bad TV series. A link to it is in the description area. I started out by cropping the subject out of the source picture. I then remove the background with the quick selection tool, leaving an approximate area where the right part of the jacket would be. I use the clone stamp tool, the burn brush, and the add noise filter to complete the jacket. I put some green over the eyeglasses and used a multiply blend and reduced opacity to finish them. I'm not going to go into detail here, as fixing the original image is not the object of this video. So for this video, you will start with a cutout picture like this. You can use your own, or if you like, I am making the modified picture on a white background available on my website. A link is in the description area. If you use it anywhere in public, be sure to give the original author credit. Open the original image in Photoshop. Resize it to 450 pixels per inch. If the subject is not cut out, I use the quick selection tool to select the white area. Then inverse the selection. Next, duplicate the selection to a layer by pressing Ctrl J. Now save the document as reference 1 PSD file. Then save it again and name it Heisenberg Bit, a PSD file. Now you should be in the Heisenberg Bit document. Change the mode to grayscale if it already isn't grayscale. Go to your levels adjustment and move the input sliders in a little bit to get a little better contrast. Next, choose filter, sharpen, unsharp mask. I set the mount to 500%, the radius to 1.1, and the threshold to 2 levels. This will vary depending on the size of your picture. You want it to look somewhat gritty. Change the mode to bitmap. Set the output to 450 pixels per inch. Set the halftone screen settings to frequency 80, angle minus 25, and shape to line. Next, we have to change our mode back to grayscale. Use size ratio of 1. Click OK. Now we're going to change back to RGB color. Open up the reference 1 PSD we created earlier. Then control click the top layer. We're going to copy it, so go to Edit, Copy Merged. Then click on the Heisenberg Bit file that's already open. Hit Edit, Paste Special, Paste in Place. Double click the background layer to unlock it. Name it BG. While the background layer is still active, control click the top layer 1. Then choose Select Inverse to invert the selection. Press Delete to remove the background from the BG layer. Press Ctrl D to deselect. Hold down the Ctrl key while pressing the New Layer icon at the bottom of the Layers panel to create a new layer below the BG layer. Name it Fill. Use your color picker to choose a foreground color. I used 82B18C. Now choose a background color of 4A491C. With your fill layer active, choose the gradient tool. Then choose the radial gradient. Now draw a line from approximately the center of the picture to the top and let go of the mouse. Of course, you could put in any type of background you wish in the fill layer. Make your top layer active. Change its blending mode to multiply. You could experiment with some other blends. Try a linear light. And try screen. However, I like multiply best for this picture. Click the adjustment layers icon at the bottom of the layers panel and choose curves. Click the clip icon to clip it. Now click in the middle of the curve line and adjust to suit. This concludes the tutorial. I hope you enjoy using this method on many different images.